Iowa college student Molly Tibbetts is dead. She was killed by an illegal alien. It's another reminder that our governing class refuses to enforce our country's laws. When they're called out on that, they deny they're doing anything wrong. Some say we should be grateful that illegal aliens enter this country freely because they are smarter, less dangerous, and generally more impressive than regular Americans. Last night, we spoke with Alex Narasta from the Cato Institute in Washington, who argued that despite breaking the law just to enter the country, illegal immigrants are far less criminal than people who were born here.
So if you want to take a look nationwide at convictions and incarcerations of people
well,
by immigration status, that's a much better way to do it, and then you get
it would be, but we don't have those data. The most comprehensive data we have are from the federal system. And
no,
so when
that's not true.
44
that's not,
well
that's
it,
not true,
it is true actually. Not every state keeps those data. I know the answer
the state
to
of
this
Texas
question.
Does. The state of Texas actually
that
does
is
record
one,
convictions
okay.
by immigration
okay.
status
it's
and Texas
one
is a great
among
state has a lot
50.
Of illegal immigrants.
Peter Kirsten now knows a lot about this subject. He's a lawyer, a US Civil Rights Commissioner, and the author of the book Second Strike. He joins us tonight. Peter, thank you very much for coming on. So it seems like a simple question to answer, because it's a data-based question. To what extent do people here illegally add to our crime problem? Do we know the answer?
We have a pretty good understanding of it, and it's significant. I heard your lead-in, and you're absolutely right. You have to disaggregate data because the various organs of both federal and state government consciously avoid getting this data. You could probably find out, for example, how many Norwegian prisoners there are in Minnesota. But it's difficult to disaggregate data with respect to illegal aliens, but it can be done. There's something called the State Criminal Alien Assistance Program, and you can extrapolate from that and get pretty reliable data. Now, Alex is very knowledgeable, and that's why it's puzzling that he won't acknowledge the overwhelming amount of data that shows that illegal aliens not only commit more crimes at a higher rate, that is, than lawful residents, but more serious crimes at a far higher rate than lawful residents. And we're not talking about a little bit. He conveniently mentioned Texas to claim that the homicide rates among illegal aliens is 44% lower than that for lawful residents. He chose the one state where it is true that the homicide rate is lower for illegal aliens by 15%, not 44%. But if you look at every other state, it's significant how much more, not just the homicide rate, but every other serious crime, rape, aggravated assault, you name it, so much more. For example, in New York, 27% of incarcerated illegal aliens are incarcerated for murder, not jaywalking. We did a study, Carissa Mulder and I did a study with respect to five states, five largest states, to see how many illegal aliens were incarcerated for homicide. Texas, New York, Florida, California, and Arizona. 5,400 illegal aliens are incarcerated for homicide. That's just homicide. There are over 300,000 illegal aliens incarcerated. We're talking billions of dollars in incarceration costs and all other kinds of costs. And the base that open borders advocates often steal is that they don't count the millions of offenses and crimes committed by illegal aliens, such as document theft, Social Security, driver's right. licenses, but also illegal appropriation of welfare benefits. And we're talking about billions of dollars. Let's put that aside and let's just talk about the more serious crimes. John Lott did probably the most methodologically rigorous and comprehensive examination of this by using Arizona Department of Corrections data.
Yes.
And he went over a 30-year period. This was exhaustive, and this is what he does. He's a scholar. And what he showed is that illegal aliens don't just commit more crime or more serious crimes by, say, 5% more or 10% more than lawful residents, but by 250% more. For a long time, when I listened to, for example, people talking heads on television, and you know, at the Civil Rights Commission, every once in a while someone tries to pull a fast one on us, I'm astonished by the fact that we have copious data on this. And it appears as if there are a lot of entrenched interests that want to make us believe that this is not a serious issue. Americans are being slaughtered. Americans are suffering property damage in the billions of dollars. Americans are spending billions of tax dollars to address this problem, both from a law enforcement standpoint, an incarceration standpoint,
and by the way, just the social carnage. You think we'd have the right to know? I mean, maybe Americans would decide, you know, it's worth it. Actually, I want more illegal aliens here. Maybe they wouldn't, but we have a right to the information. That's why I'm so grateful that you came tonight. Peter Kirsten, thank you very much for that.